just want to start baking. Okay. So, we pour these in.
What are these?
They are, they're like butterscotch chips. Like chocolate chips, but made with butterscotch.
And then what are those?
Chocolate chips.
Okay.
So now we gotta microwave them for a while.
Why are we microwaving them?
So we can melt them. Okay, our chocolate chips are ready. Okay. I can try to mash them, see if they're melted. Got this. Try and mash it up. Okay, maybe 10 more seconds.
Okay.
So we can get.
That looks good. What are you gonna mix with the chocolate?
Some pretzels. The original Tingalings are with chow mein noodles, but I decided to do pretzels.
Oh, that's cool.
Now I just put them in. See if that's good first before I put all the rest of them in. I can use this because there's already chocolate in here. Gotta be delicate with the pretzels so they don't break. So I melted the rest of my chocolate, and here's a tip. Don't put it in the microwave for too long or the chocolate won't taste good anymore. So now I'm gonna pour it in, like what I did with my last batch. It's kind of heavy as a bowl. Okay, I melted my chocolate, mixed it up, and put it in here, and so now I get to use the spoon, scoop it up, just a little bit of it, and then put it on a spot on here.
Is that wax paper?
Yes, it's wax paper.
Okay.
Do that until you run out of it. You might have to do another piece of wax paper, but it'll still taste really good. And you also have to put it in the fridge for like an hour or two to make it so it's nice and hard. So then it'll be really yummy, and the chocolate will dry up. So it'll dry up with the pretzels. So the most important part is you have to clean it up yourself.
Is that the rule of the candy making?
Yes. Okay. Let's take them out. See if they're hardened.
Is that an hour already?
Nice, good, and hardened. Ooh, I wonder what they taste like. Maybe we took a little piece off or something. There we go. Crunchy.
Is it good?
Oh yeah, it's good. And that's how you make Tingalings in candy making and 4-H.